His belief in Allah and the messengers, the angels and the final day and the holy scriptures. To believe in destiny, that good and bad both come from him, and the resurrection. There is no God but Allah, the angels and the final day and the holy scriptures. To believe in destiny, that good and bad both come from him, and the resurrection. There is no God but Allah.
Inna alhamdulillah, nahmaduhu wa nasta'inuhu wa nastaghfiruh. ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. Dear viewers, brothers and sisters in Islam, السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. And welcome to episode number 2 from the series Tawhid First. I was planning to get into the subject, but I decided to create some more suspense. I spoke in the first episode of the series about the importance of Tawhid being the first thing which you need to become a Muslim, or if you're born a Muslim, Alhamdulillah, you're born on Tawheed. But it is also important to live it, to call people to it. So at the bed of death, you can utter the slogan of Tawheed. You can say, La ilaha illallah. Dear viewers, brothers and sisters in Islam, between the course of Tawheed first and Tawheed last, Subhanallah, you need Tawheed. Especially at the time of distress, at the time of need. Something which strikes me is a supplication in our religion called Dua al-Karb. The supplication of distress. When you're desperate, when no one can help you, you're supposed to make this dua. The dua is compiled in Sahih al-Imam al-Bukhari, Hadith Abdullah ibn Abbas, radiyallahu anhuma. You see, brothers and sisters in Islam, you're supposed to say the following. La ilaha illallah al-azim al-halim. La ilaha illallah, Rabbul Arsh al-Azim. La ilaha illallah, Rabbul Samawati, wa Rabbul Ardi, wa Rabbul Arsh al-Kareem. You tell me, where is the dua here? Brothers and sisters in Islam, the scholars say that there are three types of dua: supplications, invocations, which a Muslim can make. The first one, dua al-haja. When you're needing something, you can name it. You can ask Allah for it. The second type, dua al-ibadah. The dua that you make during the rituals. Like when you're bowing down in ruku', you say, Subhan Rabbi al-Azim. And when you are in prostration, you say, Subhan Rabbi al-A'la. But there is a third type of dua called dua al-thana, that you praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, is a form of dua. And the best way to praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is to call upon him with Tawheed. That is why Yunus, Jonah, in the belly of the whale, when he was so distressed and in need, so desperate. That is the dua which he used.
وَذَنُّونِ إِذْ ذَهَبَ مُغَاضِبًا فَظَنَّ أَنْ لَنْ نَقْدِرَ عَلَيْهِ فنادى في الظلمات أن لا إله إلا أنت سبحانك إني كنت من الظالمين.
The noon, Yunus, Jana in the belly of the whale, needing help. He needs to get out of that darkness. The darkness of the belly of the whale, inside the darkness of the body of the whale, inside the darkness of the sea. He praised Allah with Tawhid. So when you're distressed, brothers and sisters in Islam, the best thing you can use to call upon Allah is Tawhid. Because Allah knows what you need. We do not have to say exactly what we want with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Yes, we do this with the humans to let them know our needs. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows exactly what you want. You're amazed when the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam tells you, كما في حديث عمرو بن شعيب عن أبيه عن جده والحديث في سنن الترمذي. عمرو بن شعيب predecessors, the hadith is chained all the way back to Abdullah ibn Amr ibn al-As رضي الله عنهما, the companion. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم says, خير الدعاء دعاء يوم عرفة. The best day to make dua is the dua which you make on the day of Arafah during Hajj. وَخَيْرُ مَا قُلْتُ أَنَا وَالنَّبِيُّونَ مِنْ قَبْلِي. And the best dua which I made and the prophets before me is what? لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ وَحْدَهُ لَا شَرِيكَ لَهُ لَهُ الْمُلْكُ وَلَهُ الْحَمْدُ يُحْيِي وَيُمِيتُ وَهُوَ عَلَىٰ كُلِّ شَيْءٍ قَدِيرٌ. Again, dua. We're talking about dua. But you see, if you praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, if you glorify, magnify Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with tawheed, Allah will give you what you want. وفي مستدرك الحاكم, dear viewers, حديث أبي سعيد الخدري رضي الله عنه, Musa alayhi salam, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam narrates that Musa alayhi salam one day he asked Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to teach him a dua with which he can call upon Allah with it. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said to him, and we know Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala spoke to Musa alayhi salam. وكلم الله موسى تكليما. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said to him, Ya Musa, O Musa, قُلْ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ. Call upon me with لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ, O Musa. Musa alayhi salam said to him, O Allah, everybody says it. Everyone, every Muslim يعني, says it. Can you teach me something different? Something else special? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says to him, Ya Musa, قُلْ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ. Say, La ilaha illallah, wa izzati wa jalali, by my might and my glory, law wudi'at al-ardiyun al-sab'h, wa al-samawatu al-sab'h, wa man fihin, fi kaffa, wa la ilaha illallah, fi kaffa, lamalat bihinna la ilaha illallah. By my might and glory, if the heavens and the earth and whatever in them and in between them is to be placed in one pan of the scale, and la ilaha illallah is in the other pan of the scale, la ilaha illallah would outweigh all of this. Dear viewers, if there is something which you need when you leave this world, When you are a loner in the day of resurrection, is La ilaha illallah. The day of resurrection, brothers and sisters in Islam, is a heavy day, 50,000 years long. All mankind, from Adam until the last soul born, will be in one place, naked. No one cares for you. No one. Even your family member will abandon you.
يَوْمَ يَفِرُّ الْمَرْءُ مِنْ أَخِيهِ وَأُمِّهِ وَأَبِيهِ وَصَاحِبَتِهِ وَبَنِيهِ لِكُلِّ امْرِئٍ مِّنْهُمْ يَوْمَئِذٍ شَأْنٌ يُغْنِيهِ.
Your brother will flee from you, will flee from you. Father, mother, wife, children will not know you. You're alone. Subhanallah, as a matter of fact, your family members would love to use you as a ransom to save them.
يُبَصَّرُونَهُمْ.
They will see you. You will see them.
يَوَدُّ الْمُجْرِمُ لَوْ يَفْتَدِي مِنْ عَذَابِ يَوْمِئِذٍ بِبَنِيهِ.
The transgressor would love to use his children as a ransom for him to be saved. Guess what will help you in this day, dear viewers? Is La ilaha illallah. La ilaha illallah, with it, there is a big chance for your salvation to be saved. The least La ilaha illallah will do for you, it will save you from hell. It will take you out of hell. The least. Of course, if you learn it, implement it, you can actually go to Jannah, go to paradise, without reckoning, without punishment. Dear viewers, in the next segment of Tawhid First, I would like to shed more light on why you need to die with La ilaha illallah, because it will save you in the day of resurrection. But again, my message here is, in order to have it, you must learn it and you must act upon it. And this is the objective of this series of episodes. Let's take a short break. We'll be right back. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
It is belief in Allah and the messengers, the angels and the final day and the holy scripture.
Ramadan is here.
We're only a few sunsets away from the month of change, an opportunity that is given to us only once a year. Take a look at this. Take a look at your future. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. It's a very windy and dusty day here. We're about an hour out of Cairo in the middle of the desert. Al-Ikhlas, sincerity. Whether you are alone in the middle of the ocean, in a boat, or on a river, or in a busy city street, your only way to success in this life and the next is through sincerity.
Methanol, which is the fuel that is used for rockets, that is placed inside cigarettes, that we're putting into our bodies when we're breaking our fast. Subhanallah.
Together, let's plant the seeds of change.
Ooh, seeds of change.
Allah and the messengers, the angels and the final day and the holy scripture.
Assalamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Welcome back, dear viewers. Tawhid first. You need la ilaha illallah. You need Tawhid, dear viewers, in the day of resurrection. Listen, without Tawhid, without La ilaha illallah, your chance for salvation is zero. You need an evidence? You know Ibrahim alayhi salam, the prophet, he had a father whose name is Azar. He called him to Islam. He called him to La ilaha illallah. He refused. He rejected. He actually called him in a very beautiful, eloquent, polite father-son conversation. Read the context of his da'wah to his father in Surah Maryam.
واذكر في الكتاب إبراهيم إنه كان صديقا نبيا.
Mention in the book Ibrahim, he was a truthful prophet.
إذ قال لأبيه يا أبت لم تعبد ما لا يسمع ولا يبصر ولا يغني عنك شيئا.
Daddy, father, أبي. Very soft. Why do you worship idols which doesn't hear, doesn't see, and it will not help you?
يا أبت إني قد جاءني من العلم ما لم يأتك فاتبعني أهدك صراطا سويا.
Father, I was given knowledge which you do not have. Follow me, my father. I will guide you to a straight path.
يا أبت لا تعبد الشيطان إن الشيطان كان للرحمن عصيا.
My father, worship not Shaitan. Shaitan is a disobedient to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
يا أبت إني أخاف أن يمسك عذاب من الرحمن فتكون للشيطان وليا.
Father, I'm afraid Allah will punish you. Will punish you. The Most Merciful will punish you and you become a follower to Shaitan. Look at this soft, kind language of da'wah. Look at the reaction of his father.
قال أراغب أنت عن آلهتي يا إبراهيم لئن لم تنته لأرجمنك واهجرني مليا.
Ibrahim, you don't like my idols? If you do not stop, I will stone you to death or leave. Look at the reaction, brothers and sisters in Islam, of Ibrahim.
قال سلام عليك.
Peace, father. In Sahih al-Bukhari wa Muslim, Hadith Abi Huraira, رضي الله عنه, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم says,
يلقى إبراهيم أباه آزر يوم القيامة.
Ibrahim will meet his father Azar in the day of resurrection. وعلى وجه Azar غبره وقتره. And the face of Azar, the father of Ibrahim, will be dusted, darkened. My faces in the day of resurrection, my dear viewers, are two types.
وجوه يومئذ مسفرة ضاحكة مستبشرة.
Faces on that day will be booming, would be beaming in happiness, shiny.
وَوْجُوهٌ يَوْمَئِذٍ عَلَيْهَا غَبَرَةٌ تَرْهَقُهَا قَتَرَةٌ أولئك هم الكفرة الفجرة.
والعياذ بالله. But the faces of the disbelievers, لا إله إلا الله, will be darkened and dusted. Unhappy faces. Ibrahim عليه السلام will meet his father, and his father will say to his son, يا إبراهيم, can you save me? Can you help me? Can you help me? You're my son. Can you help me? Ibrahim will say to his father, يا أبتي, haven't I told you, ألم أقل لك ألا تعصني? Haven't I told you in the dunya, back in the world, do not disobey me and follow me, my father? He said to him, اليوم لا أعصاك. Today, my son, I will follow you. Help me. Of course, Ibrahim alayhi salam made dua. He is not to be disgraced in the day of resurrection in Surah Al-Shu'ara.
وَلَا تُخْزِنِي يَوْمَ يُبَعْثُونَ.
Ibrahim actually made that dua. Oh Allah, do not disgrace me on the day mankind will be resurrected. Ibrahim alayhi salam took the hand of his father and he went in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And he will say to Allah, Ya Rab, Ya Allah, Alam ta'idni, Alla tukhzini yawma yub'athun. Haven't you promised me not to disgrace me on the day of resurrection? Wa ayyu khizy min abi al-ab'ad. What other disgrace that my father will be thrown in hell? Brothers and sisters in Islam, hear this. Ya Ibrahim, inni harramtu al-jannata 'ala al-kafirin. Those who rejected La ilaha illallah, no mercy on that day. Even if your son is Ibrahim. Do you know who is Ibrahim? وَاتَّخَذَ اللَّهُ إِبْرَاهِيمَ خَلِيلًا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala took Ibrahim for a friend. When Mu'ad ibn Jabal recited this verse in Yemen, while he was explaining or doing something, a woman could not hold herself. And she said, قَرَّتْ عَيْنُ أُمِّ إِبْرَاهِيمِ. The mother of Ibrahim must be so happy. مَلِكُ الْمُلُوكِ اتَّخَذَ وَلَدَهَا خَلِيلًا. The king of the kings took her son for a friend. Yet, his intercession will not work for someone who did not accept لا إله إلا الله. لا إله إلا الله, dear viewers, if a Muslim, if someone who said it, would go to the hellfire for a while, we believe that people who were engaged in major sins in this dunya, in this world, and they failed to repent from it, they may have to go to the hellfire for a while. You know this verse at the beginning of Surah Al-Hashr,
ألف لام را تلك آيات الكتاب وقرآن مبين ربما يود الذين كفروا لو كانوا مسلمين.
One day the disbelievers will wish that they said لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله. When the scholars of tafsir said at the time of death, possible. The scholars of tafsir said at the time when they see the hellfire in front of them, possible. But where the consensus is, when they are in hell, everlasting stay, and the Muslims, those who said La ilaha illallah Muhammadur Rasulullah, are being called out of hell to be taken to Jannah. The disbelievers will ask one another, why those people are leaving us? Why they are leaving us? Why? Then it will be said to them, they said La ilaha illallah Muhammadur Rasulullah in the dunya. Yes, they were sinners. Yes, they fall in sin. But by the virtue of La ilaha illallah, they are coming out of hell. At this time, they will say, ah, I wish I said it. I wish I said La ilaha illallah. brothers and sisters in Islam, La ilaha illallah can send you to Jannah straight without reckoning, without punishment. If you truly understand it and implement one aspect of it, tawakkul, reliance on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Subhanallah, we have the story of a man from this ummah. Wal hadith fi mustadrak al hakim, hadith Abdullah ibn Amr ibn al As. Subhanallah, this man will be called and he will have 99 records of sins. This is the amazing piece. Each record will unfold and it will reach as far as his eyesight reaches. So he sinned. And all these records will be placed in one pan of the scale. But this is someone who understood Tawheed. This is someone who learned Tawheed and he really understood it. He was weak. He was a sinner. And this is one man from the Ummah, by the way. Those 99 records will be placed in one pan of the scale. And this card or note, in it written La ilaha illallah, will be in the other pan of the scale. It will outweigh the 99 records of sins. Brothers and sisters in Islam, this was confirmed في سنن الترمذي حديث أنس بن مالك رضي الله عنه. The Prophet says, if you come to me, لو أتيتني بقراب الأرض خطايا, son of Adam, if you come to me with earth filled with sins, but with one condition, that you do not commit shirk, I will forgive it. I want to conclude with the verse, إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يَغْفِرُ أَن يُشْرَكَ بِهِ وَيَغْفِرُ مَا دُونَ ذَٰلِكَ لِمَن يَشَاءُ. Allah will not forgive in the day of resurrection that you come with shirk, but He will forgive everything else. Are you excited now to learn about Tawheed? So you can implement it? So you can live it? So it can help you at the time of distress? So you can call people to it? So it can help you in the day of resurrection? Till the next episode of Tawheed First. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
This belief in Allah and the messengers, the angels and the final day and the holy scriptures, to believe in destiny that good and bad both come from Him, and the resurrection, there is no God but Allah, the angels and the final day and the holy scriptures, to believe in destiny that good and bad both come from Him, and the resurrection, there is no God but belief in Allah and the messengers, the angels and the final day and the holy scriptures, to believe in destiny that good and bad both come from Him, and the resurrection, there is no God but Allah.